We would like you to know something about Hindu Mahasabha. And it's a very fascinating organization, has a lot of nice professionals. And believe it or not, I think it should be clear by now that there is such a thing as a Hindu political interest that needs defending. And we are committed to that over there. And we really want many of you to come and join us if you can, and contribute your talent and your time. And because there's a lot of work to be done, and we are all eager to do it, and we need your help. I want to introduce my colleague, Dharminder Dagar. He's a very fascinating man. We are in a program to help our Hindu young men rise to their maximum potential. And that we do it through a program called mentorship. And Dharminder heads that program. So I would like you to, like him, to tell you what he does in addition to other wonderful things he does. So Dharminder Dagar.
Namaskar. And Dr. Swami, he has done a wonderful job. I think this was one of the a moving speech. So I would request everybody to give him another a rousing applause. I'd just like to add a couple of things. When Dr. Swami talked about simplicity and having the knowledge, Dr. Swami, he is a Harvard professor. He teaches over there. But yesterday when I was picking him up at the airport, I was expecting at least a couple of bags. He's traveling, coming from India. And I was so surprised when he showed up. You know, other colleague members, Sri Ramji, were there when we received him. And there was one bag. And I was asking, I said, have you left something? Or the bags have not arrived? So the simplicity of Dr. Swami was that he has a couple of clothes, pair of clothes. And I asked him, I said, sir, that's what you have? He said, yeah, I don't need anything else. So he not only goes, you know, talks about his passion and what he believes in, I think he is a practical man in that terms. So I salute him for that. Come back to, just want to put a plug for Hindu Mahasabha as well. Hindu Mahasabha, we have politically active committees. We believe in Hindu values. We believe in Hindu cause. We believe in something that as a community, as we identify ourselves as Hindus, we need to break the barrier that we are in one sampradaya or another sampradaya, we follow this particular tradition or that particular tradition. If we have a common value, we should all work together. And Hindu Mahasabha, in different form, is taken different roles, and this is one of the prime example of inviting Dr. Swami and talking about the corruption which is happening in India. I'd like to play, give some more information about our next event, Hindu Memorial Day. This is the second year we would be holding this event. And Dr. Talukdar has already talked about it, so I'll just give some more details. This event is going to be in India House on 13th of August, although 14th of August is the actual Memorial Day where we observe, I don't say we celebrate, because that's the day when India was partitioned again, and we lost so many brothers, Hindu brothers and sisters in that. This is not a event where we say that we are radicalizing anybody, or this is a radical. This is to make sure our younger generation, our current generation is aware of that what Hindus have gone through and what we should be prepared to do, so that this does not happen again. In the same event, we would be having essay competition, which we give some monies to our students so that they participate in essay and they get to it. And I talk about, I want to talk about the mentorship. Mentorship program, this would be launching. We already did one mentorship sessions in the Hindu Sports Day, which we did 2 months ago. And now we will be doing a separate, a dedicated session just to for the Hindu students or Hindustani students as well. Our focus is going to be that our Hindu students get to know each other, they start to network with a lot of people. They should not be ashamed, there should not be any barrier saying that I am Hindu and they should not be able to connect. Right now, in our society where we live, in American society, we try to mingle. But if we do mingle, that's fine, but we need to understand that we do have people who have common values and we should network with them. There are a lot of people in our society, in our community, in Houston, who have done tremendous jobs. They are established, very well distinguished professionally. We want to take advantage, we want to leverage their expertise and make sure that a high school student or a middle school student who comes over there and want to get an advice, where does they go and find the right career? If they are trying to seek a career and they try advice, where should they go? There's no community, there's no forum over here right now in our community where this thing happens. We do meet in temples, we do our pujas, but after that, we just stop at that point. This would be a forum where we would allow all our young students to network, go into a professional program, professionally run, managed program, so that they can go from one step to another step. And in this one, I'd like to request everybody who is over here to support Hindu Mahasabha in not only their financial donations, if they can, but get attached. Volunteer their time, volunteer their efforts. Everybody over here has a lot of effort and you are here for a reason. And if one thing I take in last couple of days after looking at Dr. Swami, reading through his work, is that he's so fearless. He believes, he takes action, and he actually is a practical person. If for me, this was a learning experience. When I talk to him, I see him that the infusion, the imbibe, the values which we imbibe, is that the fearlessness. And that's what I want to bring it to our young generation, that they should be fearless, they should be well connected, and they should respect the Hindu values and preserve it for next generation. And at this time I request everybody who is over here to support Hindu Mahasabha in whatever ways you can and help us do these programs again and again. Thank you so much.
So here goes. This was a very common question, so this comes first. What are the ways, Dr. Swami, that NRIs can do to make India corruption-free?
Mrs. Gandhi, well, first of all, the Intelligence Bureau told her that she'll win the election. And she didn't think she would lose. The second thing she said is that there was so much that the NRIs had created this atmosphere about lack of elections that Jimmy Carter, who had become president here, made it a point of issue with her. And she thought, anyway, I'm winning the election, so let me also remove this propaganda against me that I'm running a dictatorship. So, I mean, that is the extent to which NRIs played a role at that time. That is a special situation. Today, you certainly can continue with this demonstration. As I say, you should create an information bank. And that information should be collected. There are many interesting ways of doing it. And you can also raise issues with the Indian newspapers through certain newspaper channels that are here, based here. For instance, if you can get hold of the PTI man, PTI releases something of what you say or what you do or something in your rally, or what Baba Ramdev says in a rally here. then it will go to all newspapers, particularly the language papers, because PTI is picked up by language papers in all parts of India. You will get all India coverage. So it's an information dissemination that you can do. I don't think anything else is required from you. You're doing enough, you're already very busy people, but if this much you do, I think you have done quite a lot. Take this.
Another question was that if the Supreme Court has injunctions against ruling party members, how will it enforce its decision since it has to depend on the government to enforce the decisions?
Well, if the Supreme Court decides something and the government of India says we won't implement it, then I'm telling you it will be an international crisis. It won't be a national crisis. It will mean a signal that you don't believe in democracy. And I don't see the possibility of this government daring to do that. People will then come out on the streets. That is the mood today in the country. And I think both Ramdev's rallies as well as Anna Hazare's fast have demonstrated that now people are ready to come on short notice. Thanks to the internet, they get informed easily. And therefore, I don't think any government would dare. The only thing that we have to prevent is to make sure that some of the people of the government don't run away from the country. We have to chase them and catch them.
Check, 1, 2.
Next question. This was by Sri Surya Kaburi. He wrote his name so I can read it out. Other people didn't write their names. There is no Lokpal in the Western world. How are they differently structured from India that they are better able to manage a conflict of interest and have successful checks and balances?
Well, they don't have a Lokpal, but they can, under the constitution, appoint an independent prosecutor. They did it in the case of Nixon. They did it in the case of the Monica Lewinsky case. So, other things in the Lokpal are nothing very special. I mean, even nothing else is accepted, there's no problem. And the present laws are sufficient in India to get prosecution, provided this extra thing of an independent public prosecutor is also accepted. So, in that sense, we'll then be on the same. What happens in the United States, you have to appreciate, is they do get convictions fast on matters where there is no dispute. Like somebody confesses, then there should be no dispute at all. And there they get conviction quickly and they throw the book at that person. In America, if you get caught, then they are brutal. Martha Stewart's offense was very small, but they put her, I think, for 14 days in jail. I asked an American, why are you doing this? He says, because we have to make, 14 months. Wow. So, and you know, what is it? There was some, there is an indirect case of insider trading, but it was not, in the Indian framework I was in, I couldn't believe that you would be sent for such a long period. So, that is the skilling of Enron. And Enron is, I think, in a Houston company, no? Now, he was put in handcuffs. And he was the elite of the elite? Harvard Business School product, elite of the elite? They don't care. So, consequently, I think you can be sure that the only way we are different from the Americans is that the Americans, when they get enough evidence, they then ensure a conviction quickly. And that's what we are going to see for the first time, I think, in 2G. Although it's not, we are not dealing with one person anymore. There are so many accused. But certainly, I think, by the end of this year, Raja will be convicted and probably in jail for 21 years. Because others will follow suit, huh? Not only Raja.
That is the best news I've heard in so many years. Next question is it realistic to hope that there will be a positive and constructive change in Indian government in the near future? I think you've partly answered that, but go ahead and if you want to expand.
Well, there has to be an election, and the election is no later than 2014 for parliament. But I'm expecting an election at the end of this month. Because so many people going to jail and this government continues, it's not possible. So there will be a midterm poll at that time. I hope all the Hindus will join together and vote as Hindus. And not all 80% is necessary. 40% is enough, we'll get 2/3 majority. And with that 2/3 majority, we can do it. And if organizations which have got a reach, all India reach, like RSS, Vishwendra Parishad, Ma Ramdev, Anna Zare, some of us, all come together, then I can tell you that there will be a tsunami in voting, just as you saw in Tamil Nadu today, recently. Completely wiped out DMK. Even though DMK gave so much money, they took the money and voted against DMK.
Yes, but they brought in Jayalalitha.
Huh?
They brought in Jayalalitha again.
Well, if we had a better alternative, we would have got that person. The unfortunate BJP didn't agree with me. I told them 1 year ago that, you know, 1 year later the elections are scheduled. Let's set up candidates for all campaigning and do campaigning from now on itself, not during the election. But they were at that time searching for alliances with this party, that party. And last minute they told me, yes, we are ready, but it was too late to do anything. But next election we'll take care of Jayalalitha also, don't worry.
As a follow-up question, still Raja Kanimoli enjoy the privileges in jail as a Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha members. Why should their memberships as MPs not be automatically disqualified?
They are in jail on custody basis. They have not been convicted yet. And unless they are convicted, they cannot lose their membership. Even this being in custody basis, being denied bail is itself a very big slur on them, because it means prima facie the case against you is so strong. But once they are convicted, they will lose their membership. What is the point in their having membership anyway? They are in jail. Four prisoners are sharing one bathroom. They have no protection against mosquitoes, and it's hot as hell in this summer. They are people who have lived all their lives as in air-conditioned rooms. For them to go through this, they are already going through. They'll certainly, once they are convicted, then of course they will lose their membership. In any case, they will not be able to get elected again.
Are there any cases against Manmohan Singh for negligence as duty as of PM, or should there be any?
Well, certainly there can be cases, but I think that should happen only when he becomes ex-Prime Minister. Because at this stage, filing such a case against him means he has to step down, which means Sonia Gandhi will be empowered to nominate the next Prime Minister. And we don't want to give her that power. So let him be there till time comes to remove the government as a whole. After that, Mr. Manmohan Singh will be shown his place.
Given the current situation, do you think that the Congress Party will create chaos in India to divert public attention?
Well, I don't. To create chaos, you need people. What people they have got? When they are challenged, you see, the congressmen are very mediocre people. Some 2-3 years ago, Narayan Kataria and Harish Sani in New York, they went to my website and saw a document called Know Your Sonia, 100 pages of documents, about her and all her nefarious activities. They condensed it into a one-page advertisement in the New York Times and published it the day Sonia Gandhi arrived to deliver some lecture on Mahatma Gandhi. And she came to New York. And this was front page, it was a full page advertisement in New York Times. Everybody saw it because New York Times is read by all diplomats. And she was enraged. And so she told the Congress party, here some overseas Congress party, headed by some Malhotra, Dr. Malhotra. And they filed a $100 million case against Narayan Kataria and Arish Sahni for defamation. What happened? They are foolish enough not to know that if you file a defamation case because you defamed Sonia Gandhi and the Congress party files it, the first question that the judge is going to ask is, where is Sonia Gandhi? Because she has to come on the witness box and depose. I would like to see Sonia Gandhi come on the witness box. There will be no Sonia Gandhi. So the case got dismissed. What incompetent people these are. They will run. We have seen it in 1977. What happened to Sonia Gandhi in 1977? She took her husband and two children and ran to the Italian embassy and hid there. Morarji Desai, in my presence, called the Italian ambassador because Indira Gandhi came crying, saying that she's taken my son also and my grandchildren also. So the Italian ambassador telephoned saying, you know, no threat, don't worry, we'll die, I'm Prime Minister of India, I'll take care. Then only they came out. In Bangladesh war also, she left the country. So this time you only got to make sure that she doesn't leave the country. That's all.
Three more questions left. Who besides the Aam Aadmi supports Ramdev Ji and Anna Hazare? Any political parties, any business houses?
Oh, political parties all want to support him, but he is, maybe he'll change now, but he was of the view that politicians should be kept out because his people around him wanted him out. I was however privileged to be present when he broke the fast, when it was decided that only Sant's log, or only Sadhus will go to persuade him to give up the fast and give him the orange juice glass to break his fast. But I was made an exception. There are some people who are not happy, but Bapu Murari explained that Subramaniam Swami has got Swami name, so therefore he was also. So there is a change, and I am hoping, because you, when you are dealing with politicians, you need politicians by your side. So, but I can say that Ramdev enjoys tremendous support in the country, and all political parties would like to be associated with him.
I'm going to paraphrase this because the English is a little off. What is your opinion on why the BJP government, when it was in power, did not investigate Congress functionaries, especially Sonia Gandhi?
Well, I had filed a case in the Delhi High Court of three major charges against Sonia Gandhi. One was that she took money from KGB. And the proof I had was that when USSR collapsed and Yeltsin took over, the Americans coolly went into the KGB headquarters and photostated every document and brought out the photostat and put it in Harvard University, Princeton University and Columbia University for scholars to study. So I was in Harvard University when I was told that this big consignment from Soviet Union, from Russia has arrived. So I went and dug out Sonia Gandhi's payments and all that from KGB. And also the statement made by the spokesman of the KGB that they were giving money to Rajiv Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi and Indira Gandhi because they were very pro-Soviet and therefore in the interest of Soviet Union, we were giving them money. So I filed that in the court. Then I found that Sonia Gandhi was collecting antiques and paintings, rare paintings, as well as idols from various temples, and taking them to Italy, smuggling them. By what route? By Air India planes. They were put without customs check. And they were taken to Italy. There she had opened two shops in Italy. One in a place called Rivolta, I think it's near Milan. And that was called Etnica. And the other shop was called Ganapati in our hometown of Orbasano. And these were kept there. Now, both these are blue-collar areas. Why would they be interested in buying Indian antiques? Obviously, it was for some other purpose, was to prepare the billing for it and then take it to England and through Sotheby's sell it. So I filed that second case. Third case is that in our citizenship application, there is one very important question which has to be answered. Have you renounced your citizenship of your mother country, of the country which you were holding? And Sonia Gandhi in the application is written, not applicable. Now what does that mean? So one officer, junior officer of the Home Ministry said she cannot be given citizenship because she has put this not applicable. Indira Gandhi has overruled it. Said, no, there's no need for her to answer this question. Because she is still a citizen. And therefore, I said her citizenship should be cancelled. Now I filed this case. The High Court was persuaded, so they asked the CBI, go and find out from these countries whether this is true about those first two charges. And CBI came back and said that Russia says we are willing to give you documents if you bring a letter rogatory, which means a letter from one court to another court in Russia, where which an FIR is to be registered. And Italy also said the same thing. You bring a letter of Italy and we'll give you the documents. And they that means also for Italy, you'd have to have an FIR. So the court asked the government, file an FIR. Vajpayee government refused to file it. Vajpayee also let Rahul Gandhi off in Boston airport. He was carrying $1,60,000 in his trunks. And American law says you cannot bring in more than $10,000 unless you declare it. And the punishment is 8 years for every $10,000. So he had $1,60,000, which means 16 times. 16 times 8 is 144 years. Mr. Vajpayee's government phoned up Condoleezza Rice. Condoleezza Rice took it up with Bush. FBI resisted for 9 hours, saying, no, we will not give him up. Finally, they took an undertaking from him that whenever he is required in the United States by the FBI, he will come here. And they let him go. Of course, since then, Rahul Gandhi has never come to America. Maybe you can invite him to Houston and see what the FBI does. So, why did they do it? That I can't say. Maybe there's a cartel arrangement that I won't do anything to you, you don't do anything to me. I don't know what the problem is. There's only the BJP can answer. But certainly, the way they handled Sonia Gandhi was bad. The present president of BJP, Nitin Gadkari, his mind is clear. I can vouch for him. He is not afraid of Sonia Gandhi. But I think others seem to be a little afraid because there was one letter, strict letter, a rude letter written by Sonia Gandhi to Advani recently, saying that one think tank committee of the BJP had said that Sonia Gandhi had money in Swiss banks. So she wrote a very stiff letter. And Advani immediately apologized. What he should have said is, I am forwarding your letter to the think tank and asking them to answer you. That's what he should have done. Why should he apologize? So this is something you must ask the BJP people. but dal mein kuch kala zaruri hai.
As a follow up to those three lawsuits that you have filed, what is going on with those? How far are they?
Well, I have at the moment in court case for Mr. Chidambaram, which is coming on 24th. I have a case in the trial court saying that Chidambaram should be made an accused. In the Supreme Court, I'm only saying CBI should be asked to investigate him, because I cannot ask the Supreme Court to make him an accused. The Supreme Court doesn't have that power. That power is with the trial court. And the trial court, I have filed a petition, and that has been listed for 26th. And so on 24th, if the Supreme Court says yes, CBI should investigate, then this trial court is certain to make him a co-accused, which means next day he will have to depart for Tihar.